I would like to leave this city. This old town don't smell too pretty, and I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. So what do you say? You can't give me the dreams in your mind anyway. Half the world away.
They say the family of the 21st century is made up of friends, not relatives. Then again, maybe that's just bollocks.
This is the living room.
Oh, it's really nice.
Yeah, it's a great flat.
What's going on?
Oh, hi, are you the tenants?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I hope you don't mind. Mrs. Klein gave me the key.
What do you mean, mind?
Yeah. I'm sorry, if you'd just excuse me for a second. This is the guest bedroom. Obviously a bit of a state at the moment, but you can use it for storage, utilities, or if the pair of you want to bring a little life into this world.
Yes, it's perfect for a child.
Yes, it's very...
homey.
Yes, it's very homey. Mm.
Look, what's in here?
Would you mind telling us what's going on?
Mrs. Klein has decided to sell the house. It's a very good time, actually. House prices are up. I believe this particular property has actually trebled in value since its last purchase.
Really? Wow.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I've got to get back to the office. This place is attracting a lot of attention. I'm sure Mrs. Klein will fill you in with the relevant details.
You'd think.
Right, well, goodbye.
Excuse me, how old are you?
I'm 25 and my wife's 24.
Really?
Yes.
Bloody hell.
Do you mind? What are we gonna do?
They were younger than us.
What?
That couple, they were younger than us.
Yeah, only physically. Look, Daisy, this is serious, okay? You heard the man. The house has trebled in value. That's enough incentive for Marsh to move, let alone the fact that she's pissed off with us.
Trebled? Really?
Yes.
Wow!
We should go and lean on Brian, find out what he knows.
I like your thinking.
Thanks very much.
Where are we?
In the cupboard.
Why?
I have no idea.
Maybe it was a mistake. You know, maybe they got the wrong house, and they could have got the wrong house, couldn't they?
Shh, Brian!
Brian, are you all right?
Yes. I'm having difficulty vocalising my emotion at the moment, so I'm using this. This is a good bit. She's gone to Manchester.
Marsh has gone to Manchester?
No, Twist.
Oh, thank Christ.
Twist's gone to Manchester?
Said she needed some time to think. You know, she likes the gay scene up there.
When?
Last night. Didn't she call?
Is that Conrad?
No. No, it's Daisy.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to call you. I'm in Manchester. Loads to tell. Speak soon. Bye. Oh, I love this one. Come on, boy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yes, she did. Yeah.
I think you're upset about the house.
Why would I be upset about the house? This house is the one thing I can rely on. It's the one port in a storm. The one thing which isn't susceptible to the whims of love. It's the solid core of my otherwise painful... tortured existence. I don't know what I'll do without this old friend, you know, this rock, this island of calm in the ocean of life. What did you want to talk about, anyway?
I wonder why she went like that.
We've got to convince her to come back.
Twist.
No, Marsha. We've got to find her and we've got to say, Marsha, we're sorry. I know we've done bad, I know we've hurt you, but please, for the sake of us, for the sake of Brian, for the sake of, you know, everything, please, just don't sell the house.
Maybe not in such a whiny voice.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello, Mike.
How's Sophie?
She's very well, thank you very much.
Good. Good.
Listen, have you heard about the house, Mike?
It's tripled in value.
It's half a million, apparently.
What are you doing?
Baking. It's gone?
No, thanks. Michael, has Marcia contacted you?
Actually, I will have one.
Cream and jam inside.
Look, I... What, clotted cream?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I will then, yeah.
I have one from Martha.
No, some big guy on a motorbike came to pick up some of her stuff.
Maybe she's thrown the Hells Angels.
No. She's thrown out the Hells Angels in 82.
New behaviour.
And then where would she go? Who does she know other than us? Who would she turn to in a time of need that is or might associate with a big guy on a motorbike?
Amber!
Having no part in this.
Look, we have to find out where Amber lives.
This is all wrong.
Come on, Daisy, it's the only way.
Will you stop it?
Do you want to be homeless? Do you want to have to go out and buy loot every morning? Do you want to see what Marcia's room looks like?
Ooh.
Oh, wow, look at this.
Bloody hell.
Hey, is this what we're looking for?
42 Welland Terrace, Cricklewood. Brilliant.
Is there a phone number?
No, we're going to have to go and surprise her. Can we take the van?
Yeah, we should go and start starting her.
All right, Daisy, let's rock. Daisy.
Look.
Daisy, we don't have time for this.
There's Colin.
Colin! Colin! Colin!
Oh, my God. All right, you go ahead. All right, I'm going to go and get Colin. He's got into the neighbours.
Sod Colin?
I'm not going to sod Colin.
Get your priorities straight, Daisy. This is our home we're talking about.
Yeah, but he could get lost or run over.
He's big enough to look after himself. And when did you start giving a shit anyway?
Fine.
Oh, Daisy.
No, it's fine. Excuse me.
Well, that's just great, isn't it? We're supposed to be presenting a united front. It's not going to look very good if it's just you and me, is it?
It doesn't have to be just you and me, Tim.
You got a tape player?
No.
Thank fuck.
Okay, now listen, when we get there, right, let me do the talking, all right? I am the only one here that's capable of serious communication. So, sorry, that sounded bad. I didn't mean to suggest that you're not good communicators, all right, Mike?
Yes.
Brian? I just mean that it's partly my fault we're in this mess, all right, and I should do the talking.
What are you going to say to him?
Well... Marcia, they say the family of the 21st century is made up of friends and not relatives, and if that's true, then you're the best auntie I've ever had.
Oh. Oh.
Tim?
Hello!
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why wouldn't I be fine? It's just...
Light screen.
That's his favourite.
Why are you cooking it?
It got rather dirty. You
must be for number 23.
Yes. And I'll just be taking my dog home now.
You could stay for a cup of tea if you'd like.
Oh, no, thanks, no. We've got stuff to do.
Well, he's welcome here any time. If you're going out or something, just pop him round and I'll take good care of him.
Yeah. Thanks.
Bye. Don't be a stranger.
I'm sure you'll see him again.
I know I will.
Favourite. Why, Colin? Have I done something wrong?
Bye, Tim!
I treat you right. I don't neglect you, do I?
Not now, Colin.
But just piss off. Oh, God. I can change. I know things have been wrong between us, but what's she got that I haven't?
Here you go, love. Your favourite. Widescreen.
How did you find me?
Intuition. Help me back into your bedroom.
Yes, I'm that.
Look, you're wasting your time. I've made my mind up.
Marcia, please, just don't sell the house.
It's trebled in value.
Yeah, really? Brian.
I'd rather we just called it a day.
Marcia, we really, really want you back. What do we have to do to make you understand that?
Something bloody spectacular.
I'm sorry, OK, but just understand, we only did it because we love living there. You know, and you're a big part of that. Look, they say the family of the 21st century is made up of friends and not relatives, and if that's true, then you're the best auntie I've ever had.
Kiss my arse.
You can ask me how it went.
How'd it go?
Really badly.
Colin's gone.
What?
He went next door.
Oh, Daisy, I'm sorry. How did that happen?
Well, he walked.
Right, sorry. Sorry, my mum used to use going next door as a euphemism for being dead.
Whoa. You say my rabbit's dead?
Well, it's been 18 years, Mike. Where do you think he was?
Next door.
So that's it, then. Marsh is gone. Twist's gone. Colin's gone.
My rabbit's gone.
Mike's rabbit's gone. Everyone leaves.
Come on, Daisy, don't be silly. Not everybody leaves.
Tim, I've been offered a job in Seattle working for Marvel.
Daisy, you know when I said not everybody leaves? Well, they do. So when are you off?
Tomorrow.
Well, that's a bit short notice, isn't it?
I got the call last night. They want me to go over straight away. I'm sorry, Tim.
It's just we didn't really get a chance to see how things worked out with us.
Well, this doesn't have to be the end. We can still have sex on the internet.
That's what I was doing before. What time are you off tomorrow?
12.
Will you come with me to the airport?
Yeah, of course, of course. Marvel, eh? That's really good. So what are you planning on doing for the next 13 hours?
Right, well, I'm bushed. I'll see you guys in the morning.
Tim? What are we gonna do?
Well, short of something bloody spectacular, I've no idea. I'm off.
Sarge,
I wonder if you privates wouldn't mind doing me a little favour.
Yeah, hello? Could you tell me the times of the trains to Colwyn Bay, please? The first one. Well, the third one. Thanks. What's that?
Oh, son of the door.
Oh, Tim.
Right, yeah. that could have been a little bit embarrassing.
Get dressed.
What?
Get dressed. We're going to see Marcia. I'll be back in 5.
All right.
Ready?
Can we go later?
Why?
Frightened.
Come on, Brian, you've got to be strong. Are you a man or a mouse? Brian.
I'm a man.
Roll.
Daisy!
Ready?
Oh, okay. Right, I'll get Mike to give me a lift over to your place, okay? And I'll see you there about 11:30.
Okay. Good luck, Bisley.
With what?
With whatever it is you've got to do.
Oh, right, yeah.
It's on.
What is?
Something bloody spectacular. Oh, mama.
Are you sure about this, Mike?
Don't worry, Tim, I've done this before.
Is this all above board, Sergeant?
Are you questioning my orders, Dexter?
No, Sergeant.
Do I say, and I'll make sure you're recommended for a promotion.
I just don't see how this matter is a concern for the military.
Are we not soldiers, Dexter?
Yes, Sergeant.
Do we not have a sacred duty to keep the peace?
Yes, Sergeant.
Could you, in all good conscience, neglect to intervene in a needless, solvable conflict?
No, Sergeant.
Then get your boombox and let's rock.
What are you gonna do? Blow me up?
We're going to have such fun, you and me. It's going to be lovely. We won't need that anymore. From now on, we're going to call you Lancelot.
Oh, well, look, it came back.
Got a beer, Brian?
Nope, thanks. Got to do an installation.
Good work today, soldier.
Thanks, sir.
Hey, what's that? Tim?
Dear Tim, please forgive the letter, but I'm feeling a bit confused. Everything seems to have changed recently. We all seem to be drifting apart like leaves from a once green oak.
Skip to the end.
By the time you read this, I'll be gone. I've decided to go away for a while. Maybe a bit of distance will do me good. Who knows, if things work out, maybe I'll stay. Please give my love to everyone. I know you understand. Your friend, Daisy.
Shit!
What's the matter?
Daisy's gone.
Where?
She didn't say. Oh, thanks. Colwyn Bay, 1132 St Pancras. I've got to stop her.
What about Sophie?
Shit!
Do you need me to do another banner?
No, Brian, I don't think that's going to help, OK? Do your installation. Oh, she's not answering.
Mobile telephone.
She's still not answering. Shit!
OK, what have we got here? In the next 30 minutes, I've got to get to the station and stop Daisy.
Uh-huh.
I've got to get to Sophie's house and go with her to the airport.
Go on.
We have one means of transport.
Right.
No money for a cab. And the tubes are on strike.
Ah.
There is absolutely no way on earth we can do both. Mike?
There is a way we can do both. We do have another means of transport.
I'm not going on my skateboard.
No. What do we have other than my van, which has wheels and is slightly quicker than walking?
You've got to be fucking kidding.